The history and origin of korma. Korma or korma is a dish originating in the Indian subcontinent, consisting of meat or vegetables braised with yogurt, dahi or cream, water or stock, and spices to produce a thick sauce or glaze. Korma has its roots in the Malay cuisine of the Indian subcontinent. A characteristic Mughal dish, it can be traced back to the 16th century and to the Mughal incursions into the region. Kormas were often prepared in the Mughal court kitchens, such as the famous white korma, perhaps garnished with vark, said to have been served to Shah Jahan and his guests at the inauguration of the Taj Mahal. Classically, a korma is defined as a dish where meat or vegetables are braised with yogurt, cream or stock added. The technique covers many different styles of korma. The flavor of a korma is based on a mixture of spices, including ground coriander and cumin, combined with yogurt kept below curdling temperature and incorporated slowly and carefully with the meat juices. Traditionally, this would have been carried out in a pot set over a very low fire, with charcoal on the lathe to provide all-round heat. A korma can be mildly spiced or fiery and may use lamb, goat meat or chicken. Some kormas combine meat and vegetables such as spinach and turnip. The term shahi, in English royal, used for some kormas indicates its status as a prestige dish rather than an everyday meal and its association with the court. Variations. In the United Kingdom. In the United Kingdom, a typical korma is served in curry houses as a mildly spiced dish with a thick sauce. It often features almonds, cashews or other nuts, and coconut or coconut milk. In the 21st century, chicken korma has several times been cited as the most popular curry in the UK, replacing chicken tikka masala in surveys of public eating habits. Navratan korma. Navratan korma is a vegetarian korma made with vegetables and either paneer or nuts, or sometimes both. Navratan means 9 gems, and it is common for the recipe to include 9 different vegetables. Eid korma. In some parts of South Asia, korma is used to denote a traditional Eid al-Adha, festival of the sacrifice, dish of lamb, goat or cow that is braised in minimal or no spices. The flavor comes from the meat and fat of the chosen cuts. It was often done to preserve meats for a short-term period, as the fat layer forms a barrier to help prevent spoilage, similar to potted beef.
Ingredients for the chicken marinade. 1 kilogram of chicken. Cut into medium pieces, wash nicely and pat dry. 3 teaspoons refined oil. 1 cup curd. 1 teaspoon black pepper powder. 3 teaspoons garam masala. And 1 teaspoon salt. Method of marination. Drizzle the chicken with the oil and sprinkle on the garam masala, curry powder, salt and pepper. Add a cup of curd. Massage into the meat and cover, leaving to marinate for at least 2 hours or overnight. Method of cooking the chicken. Shift the whole marinated chicken into a deep frying pan or kadhai. Over low flame, cook the marinated chicken for at least 20 to 25 minutes. By covering the frying pan or kadhai with a lathe, stirring it occasionally, so that it doesn't get stick to the bottom. Take special care to observe that chicken don't get overcooked so that the flesh of the chicken pieces and the bones get separated. When done, keep it aside. Whole spices for saute. Bay leaves, tej patta. 2 noz. Caraway seeds, shah jeera. 1/2 teaspoon. Cloves, long, 4 to 5 pods. Cinnamon stick, dalchini. 2 noz of 1 inch. Black cardamom, badi ilaichi. 1 pods, lightly crushed. Green cardamom, choti ilaichi, 4 to 5 pods, lightly crushed. Ingredients, for the sauce. Onions, pyaz, 4 noz, medium sized, coarsely sliced. Whole red chilies, khadi lal mirch, 3 to 4 noz. Garlic, lehsun, 6 to 8 pods, coarsely sliced. Ginger, adrak, 2 inches, coarsely chopped. Tomatoes, 2 to 3 noz, medium sized, coarsely sliced. Turmeric powder, haldi powder, 3 quarters teaspoon. Coriander powder, dhania powder, 1 1/2 teaspoon. Cumin powder, jeera powder, 3 quarters teaspoon. Black pepper powder, kali mirch powder, 1 1/2 teaspoon. Garam masala powder, 1.5 teaspoon. Almonds, badam, 12 to 15 moles. Soaked in water for at least 2 hours, peeled and ground to smooth and fine paste. Low-fat yogurt, 1 cup. Canned coconut milk, nariyal ka doodh, 1 cup. Fresh cream, tazi malai, 1/2 cup. Mace jaifal, 1/4 of the whole seed. Very nicely ground to smooth powder. Salt, to taste. Refined oil, 3 to 4 tablespoon. Method of making, the korma curry. Over low heat, place a deep frying pan or kadhai, and add 1.5 tablespoon of refined oil. When the oil gets sufficiently hot and start leaving smoke, add to it 3 to 4 nose whole red chilies. Now add 4 nose coarsely sliced onion. Stir and mix the content well. Add 6 to 8 noz, coarsely sliced garlic. Fry it well, stirring it occasionally, till the garlic flakes, red chilies and coarsely sliced onion get slightly brownish. Add to it the 2 inches of coarsely chopped ginger. Cook till the coarsely sliced red chili onion ginger garlic turns golden brown. When done, shift the whole content of the kadhai to a mixer grinder jar. Allow the content to cool for 8 to 10 minutes. Then, add a 3/4 cup of water and grind the whole content till it turns into a smooth fine paste. Empty the whole chili onion garlic ginger paste in a container and keep it aside. Again place the deep frying pan or kadhai on low heat and add 1/2 teaspoon of refined oil. When the oil gets enough hot that it starts leaving smoke, add in it 2 to 3 nose coarsely sliced tomatoes. Cook it for 5 to 6 minutes, stirring it occasionally. When done, and the tomato starts leaving water, switch off the gas. Shift the whole content to a mixer grinder jar. Allow it to cool for 4 to 5 minutes. Add 1/2 cup of water and grind the tomatoes till you get a smooth fine puree. Shift the tomato puree to a container and keep it aside. Now we have in hand cooked marinated chicken, cooked chili onion garlic ginger paste, cooked tomato puree, ground almonds paste, 1 cup of low fat yogurt, 1 cup of canned coconut milk, 1/2 cup of cream, whole spices, powdered spices, the final assembly. Place a deep frying pan or kadhai over low heat. Add to it 1 to 1 1/2 tablespoon of refined oil. Allow the oil to get hot till it starts leaving smoke. Add 1/2 teaspoon of caraway seeds, Shah Jira. Add 2 loose bay leaves, Tej Patta, and 4 to 5 pods cloves, Long. Add 2 loose 1 inch cinnamon sticks, Dalchini. Add 4 to 5 pods of softly crushed green cardamoms, Choti Elaichi. Add 1 nose softly crushed black cardamom, Badi Elaichi. Fry it for 30 to 40 seconds over low heat, or till the spices changes their color and starts generating a unique spicy aroma. Note, take special care that these spices shouldn't get over-fried and burnt, as it totally spoils the taste and the unique aroma of the korma, making it slightly bitter in taste. After we are done with the whole spices, now add the prepared chili onion garlic ginger paste and the prepared tomato puree to the pan or the kadhai. Fry it till the whole content gets golden brown in color and oil starts leaving its sides. Add 1/2 teaspoon turmeric powder, that is the haldi powder. Add 3/4 teaspoon of cumin powder, that is the jeera powder. Add 1/2 teaspoon of coriander powder, dhania powder, and 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper powder, kali mirch powder. Fry, stirring the content well so that the powdered masalas gets mixed uniformly. Add 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala powder. Fry it well, stirring the contents nicely till the powdered masalas get cooked and mixed well. Next, add the prepared almond paste. Fry it for 2.5 to 3 minutes, till the almond paste gets fried enough, and oil starts leaving the sides of the whole mixture. Now, add 1 cup of low-fat yogurt. Stir, and mix the content in pan or kadhai nicely. Shake the canned coconut milk, and then, add 1 cup of coconut milk. Mix it well, and cook till it comes to boil. Once the masala mixture is done, add the cooked marinated chicken. Mix it well, slowly, and over low heat for 3 to 4 minutes, so that the chicken and the masalas gets uniformly mixed up. Bring to boil and adjust the salt. Add the ground powdered 1/4 of maize seed, that is thek jaifal. Mix it well, and switch off the gas. After a minute, add 1/2 cup of fresh cream, that is thek tazi malai. Mix well, the whole content in the pan or kadhai nicely, taking efforts that the chicken pieces don't break during stirring the korma. Shift the chicken korma to the serving bowl. Your chicken korma is ready to get served. Preparation time for marination, 20 to 25 minutes. Marination time, 2 hours or better for overnight. Cooking time for marinated chicken, 20 to 25 minutes. Preparation time for korma, 40 to 45 minutes. Cooking time for korma, 20 to 25 minutes. Course, it is a main course dish. Cuisine, Indo-Pak Mughlai cuisine. Chicken korma is a complete Indo-Pak Malai main course cuisine in itself. With its unique sweet aroma of spices, which blends uniquely with its creamy texture, and carries its own unique taste and flavor, that stands individually and holds its own prime position in the group of main course cuisine list. So try not to serve it with category of dishes like biryani, pulav, fried rice, stuffed parathas and stuffed naans. Otherwise, you will not be able to enjoy its unique aroma, smooth texture, flavor of spices and taste. Try to keep its companion straight and simple, and serve it with basmati jeera rice, plain butter naan, plain butter tandoori rotis, and plain parathas or ring parathas.